Hey everybody, I'm Nicole Ricci and I'm rolling out in my 2017 Ram ProMaster City to Everglades National Park. I'm here in the Gulf Coast Visitor Center and I just signed up for a boat tour, paid $45, and I'm about to go on, so let's go.
So I went on the 10,000 Islands tour out of the Gulf Coast Visitor Center, which is right in the Everglades City. It's a 90-minute excursion that ventures across the Chekalese Bay into Indian Key Pass and through the mangrove islands of Everglades National Park. And we had a great time. The dolphins were quite active. They were riding the back of the boat. They were actually procreating. We saw a group of them jumping out of the water, swimming, circling. It was a crazy experience. And these are the Atlantic bottlenose dolphins. So you've already seen me swimming with manatees, but I did want to share a couple of facts about them. So they have no natural predators. So they're naturally very trusting and very inquisitive, and that's why I had such good luck swimming with them. They are larger than us, and they're larger than you may think. The average adult is between 800 and 1,200 pounds and about 10 to 12 feet long. But they have been seen to weigh 3,500 pounds. So these things are huge. Even the calves are between 50 to 70 pounds and 3 to 4 feet long. They are typically slow movers, but they can reach speeds of up to 25 miles per hour for short bursts of time. And there are currently only approximately 5,500 to 6,000 manatees today. And that's thanks to the conservation and preservation efforts in the last 20 years. And I feel like I saw quite a few of those. Anyhow, the birds you're seeing now are the white pelicans, and they are large aquatic soaring birds. They are about 4 feet tall and have a wingspan of about 9 feet, and they're able to hold 11 liters or 3 gallons of water in their bill. And after I left Everglades National Park, I went through a car wash, which turns out to be a big mistake because then I went down a dirt road in Big Cypress National Preserve.
It's the next day and I am kayaking in Turner River. I'm in my kayak. Here I am. Okay. I'm kayaking in the mangroves in this narrow passage. Can you tell how narrow this is? Like, my boat is barely getting through and I don't like this at all. I don't like this at all. I just started maybe half an hour ago. I don't know how I'm going to go. I have ran into probably 50 spider webs. I wish you could just see what I'm going through right now. Like, I'm touching basically both sides. It's, you know, like my favorite part of Alaska when I'm in the inside passage and these narrow. I don't like it when I'm in this little boat and there's spiders all over here. So, wow, I need to turn my camera around and show you this. My gosh, I just feel like I've gone through, like, I'm breaking the spider web net. It goes across and I'm breaking it with my body, my face, my chest, my arms. You know when you feel like you have spider webs on you? That's how I feel. All over my arms. I feel like I keep having things crawl on me. I can't really tell. This is not what I was expecting. She told me, you know, you're gonna have to take apart your paddle because you're gonna be in these skinny passages where your paddle can't even fit through, so you're gonna, you know, more like a canoe instead of a kayak. This is not fun. It reminds me when I was a child, I was on my grandma and Grandpa Smith, Grandpa Tom and Grandma Shar. They had this like a balcony, I guess, on there. It was a deck. And I leaned over, I think, to talk to my dad. And there was a big spider web and I just like leaned right into it. And this is like that, but times 100. I'm like in the bushes. I need to stop. To make matters worse, I literally just saw an alligator, and I'm telling you, it's like 3 feet away from me. You know, this is a really narrow river. I just saw an alligator. Oh my gosh.
So the difference between a crocodile and an alligator is American crocodiles have pointier snouts and are lighter colored than alligators, and they prefer coastal areas of the South Florida. So I think most of what I saw were alligators, if not all of what I saw were all alligators. And these big fish are the Florida gar.
Kayaking through the mangroves. They say it's fun. Go through the mangroves. No, no, this is crazy. Okay, I feel like I'm doing the monkey bars instead of paddling, because you just grab on to these trees. You know, I'm basically laying down. Oh my gosh, a spider web. So I just keep grabbing the trees instead of paddling. I didn't bring my GoPro today. It was stupid me. So I just pushed myself along like this. I feel, you know, like, yeah, kind of like the monkey bars instead of paddling. What a unique experience. The mangroves of Florida and the spider webs. Oh my gosh.
This is who we worship tonight, yeah. He's the same, he's the same. Oh God, how I need you, yeah. How I need.
Guys, I'm kayaking through the river. There's the alligator, right there. Yeah, you can't zoom in, but there it is. It's literally right there. Wow.
You freed the captives, you're freeing hearts right now. You are the same God, you are the same God. You touch the lepers, I feel your touch right now. You are the same God, you are the same God. Every change, oh, forever. We feel you now. You're the same God. You're the same God, yeah. How we need you now, yeah.
So I paddled for about 3.5 hours. I went up the river one way to the end and then down the river. I think, yeah, I did about 3 miles, was on the river like 3.5 hours. And now I'm just eating a chicken salad sandwich.
I'm calling on the Holy Spirit.
All right, now I am walking at the boardwalk at H.P. Williams and Kirby Storter Roadside Parks.
You're the same God, yeah. How we need you now, yeah. I'm calling on the Holy Spirit. Oh, mighty river, come and fill me again. Let that be your prayer tonight. Come and fill me. Come and fill me, come and fill me again.
All right, now I am at the Oasis Visitor Center of Big Cypress National Preserve, and I'm here on the state trail of Florida, the Florida National Scenic Trail. So I don't know how far across the state this goes, but I'll just do a couple miles here, but it's pretty beautiful.
The Florida National Scenic Trail covers 1,500 miles across the state of Florida. And also, I just wanted to share a bit about the difference between Everglades National Park and Big Cypress National Preserve, both of which I show in this video. The National Preserve is north of Everglades, which is in the south. The preserve is a little bit different because it allows for a broader spectrum of uses than the national park. Oil and gas exploration and production, hunting, off-road vehicle access, retention of private property, and the traditional and customary use and occupancy by the Misuski and Seminole people are all acceptable activities within the preserve versus the national park.
Hallelujah!
degrees. I am sweating so much. I don't think I'm going to be getting a shower tonight, but I need one. It's going to be a wipey shower tonight. I am headed to the Big Cypress Loop Road. I think it should take me about 2 hours. It's currently 2:30. Take me 2 hours to drive slowly. I'm going to stop. I'm going to see some more alligators. And I'm also going to do a couple of hikes. Guys, this is a real alligator right here. There's nothing, you know, I'm right here. It's right there. This drive has been crazy. I've seen probably 100 alligators just driving by. They're right on the road. They're swimming in the water. This guy's a little bit smaller, so I felt safer to stand by him. Otherwise, I'd just stay in my car. But look at him. Wow. Oh man. There's all these lizards, but I was just walking on this trail and this little snake, it just went through. Oh my gosh. Just crossed my path. Ugh. Look at this guy. Wow. Oh my goodness. This one has its mouth open. And I'm right here. This is the road I was driving on. Wow, I don't even know if I want to get that close. Why is he not afraid? He's really frozen. Whoa. Good morning vlog, it's the next day. I'm at the Shark Valley Visitor Center and I'm going to attempt to run slash walk 15 miles on the tram road to their little tower. It's a nice walk. Lots of people bike it, lots of people take the tram. I'm gonna save some money and just walk it. Hopefully it won't take me more than a few hours. Yes, I'm wearing the same shirt 3 days in a row. Don't worry, I'm gonna shower today. I only have one tank top. So this is what we got. Wish me the best of luck. And hopefully I'll see some more alligators today. I'm 0.6 miles in and I just ran past my first alligator. But I'm not slowing down because I gotta keep going for this first stretch. Okay, I had my phone in my hand, just not my second one. So I just slowed down a teeny bit to get that guy, but not really because I'm still moving. I've gone 2 miles so far, 2 miles so far. Here's a big gator right here. So this is a trail, look at this. You know, these gators are just right here. Wow. I made it to the tower. Oh, 7 miles took me an hour 45. Oh my gosh. Thank goodness for the clouds and the wind. whole tower to myself. I bet this rarely happens. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna enjoy it. The shade. There was actually a water fountain here, so I drank the whole thing. I'm gonna drink this whole thing before I go. Woo. You are a lion and cheer. I declare that you are my Lord and King.
And you're holy, you're so worthy of all the glory. You are mighty, you're holy, so worthy.
I tell you, I'm on the way back. So it's 8 miles on the way back, a little bit longer. And I'm struggling, it's like almost 90 degrees out here. I'm just trying to keep it together. I'm almost back.
I just got in my car, I changed my shirt because I just wanted to get out of that sweaty outfit. 4 hours, 45 minutes it took me for the 15 miles, and that includes like a 45 minute break that I did at the tower. I just like sat down at the top and then at the bottom. Wow, yeah, my car is reading 86 degrees right now. It was so hot. I got sunburned, my body is tired. Wow, but it was cool. Saw lots of gators, definitely over 20. I heard people say they saw over 50. I didn't see that many. But, you know, saw lots of birds, lots of sandhill cranes, some really beautiful, colorful birds. It was a great time. Saw some turtles. Yeah. Now I am headed for, you know, another adventure in the Everglades. I'm headed to Gator Park for an airboat tour. So yes, this is my second boat tour in the Everglades. It's hard because the majority of the park is in the water, and so I do want to see it. I'm here, so I paid for another tour. I'm headed there right now. It's a 40-minute airboat tour and then a 20-minute wildlife show, so not sure all that it'll be. Hopefully it'll be awesome. It's 2:30 right now, and I have the rest of the day to spend there, so let's go.
Of a God that is worthy of all the praise that you can give him right now. Come on, lift up your voice and magnify his name. Come on, say, you are mighty, yes, mighty, and you're holy, so worthy of the glory. You are mighty, you're holy, so worthy of glory. You are mighty, you're holy, so worthy of glory. You're good to me, Lord. Against me, yes.
Listen, no weapon formed against you, private enemies shall prosper. But you've got a weapon that will always have power. Your weapon is praise for the rest of your days. You stomp on the devil and lift Jesus' name. My praise is the weapon.
My praise is the weapon.
It's a declaration.
Yes, it's a declaration.
My God is king.
My God is king.
Do you believe he can do anything tonight? Said my praise is a weapon.
My praise is a weapon.
It's a revelation.
It's a revelation.
That if God be for me, tell me who can be against me. Listen, no weapon formed against you by the enemy shall prosper. But you've got a weapon that will always have power. Your weapon is praise for the rest of your days. Stomp on the devil and lift Jesus' name. He's the Alpha. Omega, Jehovah, Messiah,
healer,
deliverer,
my
victory
from the enemy.
Come on, use your weapon of praise. Clap your hands, lift your voice. Magnify the God of your salvation. He's worthy of praise.
Currently in a Planet Fitness bathroom. They have a charger, so I'm enjoying that. It was a crazy couple hours leaving that boat tour and driving to Miami. I had to go and pick up this package from an Amazon hub locker, and I couldn't find the Amazon hub locker. It was in a Ross store on the 6th floor, which they didn't tell me. I was kind of stupid to pick that location to pick it up. I thought it was gonna be easier. I did not realize how big of a city Miami was and how much traffic there would be at rush hour. Anyhow, I'm now in Homestead and I am going to sleep really good after a long day and a warm shower. This has been a long vlog. Thank you for keeping up with me through the Everglades, through the National Forest, and I will see you guys in the next one. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe. I'll see you next time. Bye. Bye.